and see the bigger picture. It's good to be alive. It's good to be alive. Nobody is an island. We are part of an environment. Only way we gonna survive is if we harmonize. We're not alone. We're not alone. We're not alone. We're not alone.
Reginald Lewis, the black billionaire before Oprah, Bob Johnson. How'd he disappear? Conspiracy theories, UFOs in the air. I seen it with my own.
Hi, this is Green Justice reporting live from State College, Pennsylvania. So, I'm here to talk about three things that I would love to see come out of the Copenhagen talks this year. And the first thing is I want to congratulate the White House for bringing together youth across the country on a clean energy economy. Great first step. Would love to see some action, and I really hope that your White House staff goes ahead and begins to take the solutions we came up with into consideration. Secondly, I would really like to see some type of agreement made. I understand that there's no legal framework being made, but what would be amazing is to see an agreement between all of the world's powers to not use clean coal technologies, biomass, nuclear, just name a few, which are very detrimental to the health of so many Americans and so many people across the world, especially those who live near them. And most of those people who live near them are not the wealthy of either one of the nations. Secondly, America be the leader. we're the first to go to space. We have so much potential and so much energy and so many people that are really willing to work on this issue. So instead of getting caught up on bureaucratic ties between corporations and the people, be a leader and represent the people of America. And when you represent the people of America, you'll do amazingly well on this whole climate issue. But in being a leader, that means we have to do several things. One, we have to get rid of cap and trade out of our legislation. A cap, amazing. No, really, honestly, like I really like the idea of capping emissions and capping emissions at a reasonable rate that the United States could then use to build down. So it'd be the same as if you matched your credit card. Okay, your tax limit or credit limit was $5 trillion, and now you've capped it. Oh crap, you can't go over it. So now you have to strategically pay off your credit card until it goes down. And we should do the same with emissions. We should cap it at a particular ppm, particularly the current parts per million of carbon dioxide we have in the atmosphere now, which is 380. And it'd be ideal if we could bring it down to 350, and then from there either maintain it or bring it even lower, which would be great, at 320 or below. You know, we got to where we were because of the Industrial Revolution, and we went from 280 parts per million over 150 years ago to now 380, which is double in 100 years, and double within the past 30 years, which is crazy. But a trade system not only would not work efficiently with capping, but it would also create a lockout market that would keep the people, the very same people that were working to get them jobs in America, from having jobs or from even being able to work in our green capitalistic market that we're proposing in our both of our climate legislations. And lastly, include people of color in the climate discussion. I was so glad when I went to the White House and I saw people from D.C. and New York and Philadelphia and Detroit and from the tribal nations. You have to keep the conversation open with these people, and I'm going to need Secretary Chu and Salazar and Solis and Administrator Jackson to continuously keep the ear to the ground as to what the people of this nation truly need, and not want to advocate for or put people at risk just to become the leader. We can still be the leader without having people choose their health for jobs or their livelihood for cleaner energy, or what we say is cleaner energy. And I'll leave you with this quote. Kofi Annan said that it is the more developed country's responsibility crap.
We got work to do.
It feels so good. Making a change in our community. From me to you, just a message. Obama for America. You know.